Welcome back to Buckeye Bigfoot. Now, a few weeks ago, I gave you two encounters exactly as I received them in my email. No tinkering from Nance. Everyone liked those. So, I'm going to give you another one straight from my email today. Now, we have all heard that music soothes the beast, but is that true? You know, studies have repeatedly shown that animals, and even plants, are reactive to music. It's been proven repeatedly that cows have a noticeably higher production of milk when they listen to classical music. Change the music to rock music, and the milk production drops dramatically. Horses? They will synchronize their pace to music with no human encouragement. The list of studies proving how much music affects animals is long and irrefutable. We humans take music for granted over the last couple centuries. With the push of a button now on our iPods, we can listen to music uninterrupted for weeks, maybe months. We drive around with music in our cars. Some of us listen to the radio all day as we work. And we women, we're notorious for playing music while we do our housework. In short, as humans, our days are filled with music if we so choose it. It entertains us, fills the silence in our lives, and becomes the backdrop for the autobiographical memories in our heads. So what about a Sasquatch? They live in a world that, for the most part, consists of quiet forest noises. How profound must beautiful music seem to them? Well, the submitter of the email for today gives us that answer. The submitter, Kathy, asked that I not be too specific about where her brother lives in this story, but she was okay with me telling you that it's up in Muskingum County. And if you're curious, there will be a link to the piece of music that she's playing at the end of this video, and I'll put up the name of it on the screen as well. Okay, let's get into Music Soothes the Sasquatch. In 2008, my husband was helping my brother remodel the downstairs family room at his house. Off the family room was a three-season room that was half dug in the ground, meaning brick halfway up inside to above the ground level and then the windows above. So when you stood in it, the brick came to about waist high. I hope that makes sense. Anyway, this faced the back of the property, which had trees starting about 50 feet from that side of the house. I think there was a creek back there too, if I remember right. Anyway, the guys had stored lots of things from the family room in the three-season room so they could work. One of those things was my mother's spinet piano. It was the one I had learned to play on growing up, and I was glad my brother had kept it. I was bored while they had gone to Home Depot for some stuff, and I went down to check on their progress and see what they had gotten done. I looked in the three-season room and saw the piano, and I could not resist. I uncovered it, pulled out the bench, and began playing one of the more recent pieces I had learned by heart called Vladimir's Blues. I was getting frustrated because there are some tricky mezzo forte and legato in that piece, and I was trying to go by memory only. So I had to play a lot of the parts repeatedly, and sometimes I was replaying the whole thing too from beginning to end. I had a clear view over the short piano to the trees. At one point, I looked up over the piano while playing and saw a dark shape out there by the trees. I ignored it and kept playing. I looked up later and it was gone. Now, I looked to my right and saw it had come closer and was almost across from the sunroom directly, which, by the way, because they had been working down there, all the windows were open. I knew I was looking at a Bigfoot. I had a clear view of less than 20 feet from where I sat at the piano. It just stood there and kept listening. So I kept playing. It seemed peaceful and it wasn't threatening, so I wasn't afraid. However, when the guys pulled up in the driveway, the Bigfoot took off back in the trees. I told my brother and husband, and at first my husband didn't believe me, but my brother did. He said he has sat out there and back with a radio, and sometimes that Bigfoot will come and listen, and it will stay just inside the trees, but he can see it. He said it doesn't like rock and roll or hip-hop, but it does seem to like any slower music. But he also told me it had never come so close to listen to the music before. I like to think it was my choice of music that got the Bigfoot to come in so close. Okay, folks, I have to tell you, I've listened to the piece of music Kathy says she was practicing, and I have to say I am utterly enchanted with it. The piece of music is really short, only about a minute long, but if you look up in the right corner, there's the link to Vladimir's Blues by Max Richter. Have a listen, and tell me what you think of it. Try to imagine the strains of that piano music filtering through the trees to reach a Bigfoot's ears. I don't know what you think of it, but I can't help but imagine that music would seem enchanting, maybe a bit mysterious and wondrous to a Bigfoot who, unlike us, can't listen to music whenever he chooses. Folks, where we're going to wrap it up for this Bigfoot Palooza weekend, and maybe I can get enough encounters together to do another for Labor Day. I hope so. Thanks for being with me on this weekend. I hope everyone had a wonderful and safe 4th of July. And until we meet up again this coming Friday, always remember, absence of proof is not proof of absence. I'm Nance Warren. Thanks for listening. Have a good evening, folks. If you've enjoyed this encounter and would like to hear more, please hit the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell to get all your notifications.